Good morning, students. How are you all? Yes, I hope you all are good at home, safe at home, studying well, and enjoying your holidays. My dear students, today I have come with a new topic. It is noun. Before that, my dear students, let me know in English grammar, parts of speech is one such a topic which is very important for the students of class 1 onwards to any higher class. If a student learns parts of speech thoroughly and properly, he can understand any grammar topic in English language easily. Because parts of speech is the basic English grammar topic, very basic fundamental grammar topic. Parts of speech, when you are in class 1, you must have studied. They are 8: noun, pronoun, verb, adverb, adjective, preposition, conjunction, interjection. Noun, pronoun, verb, adverb, adjective, preposition, conjunction, and interjection. These are the 8 words and 8 parts of speech. Every part of speech has its own importance. Noun is important, equally pronoun, verb, adverb, adjective, preposition, conjunction, interjection, all are important. So today, let us discuss, let us know, let us get some information about noun. A noun is a naming word. A noun refers to a person, a place, or a thing. A noun is a naming word. It refers to or it tells about the name of a person, or the name of a place, or the name of a thing. It refers to person or persons, place or places, thing or things. So, nouns are 5 kinds: proper noun, common noun, collective noun, material noun, and abstract noun. 5 types are there: proper noun, common noun, collective noun, material noun, and abstract noun. So today, let us learn common noun and proper noun. Common and proper nouns. What is a common noun? First, we should understand what is it. Common nouns are words used for general items, not the specific one. Common nouns are words used for general items, not the specific ones. We use for common person or common place or common thing. So a common noun is used for a common person or common place or common thing or general thing or general place or general person. It is in general we use. It is not used for a specific or particular person. We cannot use common noun for a specific or particular place, specific or particular animal. So that's why it is given not the specific ones. It is not for specific or particular persons. So here common nouns are words used for general items or in common items we use common nouns. For example, mother. Mother is a common word. Father, a common word, a common noun. Boy, a common word or noun, common noun. Girl, table, book, pen, dog, cat, bird, city, town, doctor, teacher, player, driver. These are common nouns or common words which do not have any specific name or a particular name. Without having a name, all these words we call common nouns. Similarly, if you look at second one, proper noun, it is quite different from common noun. Now, what is proper noun? Let us see. Proper noun. Proper nouns are words used for a particular kind of persons, places and things. Proper nouns are words used for a particular kind of persons, places and things. It is used for a particular person. Proper noun is used for a particular place. Proper noun is used for a particular thing. And second point, a proper noun always begins with a capital letter. It always begins with a capital letter. Whereas a common noun need not to start with a capital letter. You can see here mother M cap, M small, father F small, boy B small letter, G small letter, T small letter, B small letter. All first letters you can see in common nouns, you will find small letters. Whereas in proper noun, the second rule says it always should begin with a capital letter, because it refers to a particular person, a particular place, a particular thing. For example, Rajesh. Rajesh is the name of a particular person. It is not all boys are Rajesh. It is not that. It is the name of a one particular boy. For example, you take boy. Boy is common noun. When this boy has a name Rajesh, then Rajesh become proper noun. Similarly, Geeta, girl, common noun, and this girl has a name, for example, Geeta. So Geeta is proper noun. So girl is common noun, Geeta is proper noun. Similarly, Rose. proper noun.
Titanic.
A proper noun.
Titanic. What is Titanic?
It is the name of a ship. Now ship is common noun.
When we call the ship with a name Titanic,
that Titanic is proper noun.
Monday. For example, day. Day is a common noun. No name, it is common, general, day. But that day, when it has Monday, when it has a name, Monday, then Monday will become proper noun, Monday. It is the name of a day, Monday.
July.
July is the name of a month. Now, month is a common noun. July is proper noun because July is the name of a month.
India.
India is the name of a country. Our country is India. Country, common noun. India, proper noun. Very simple.
Next, Yamuna.
Yamuna, it can be the name of a girl, name of a river. If you take it name of a river, so Yamuna is a proper noun. River is common noun, Yamuna is proper noun. Because Yamuna is the name of that river. So Yamuna, you see below that I underline. So all the first letters you can see underlines. So underline indicates first letter must be capital letter. Similarly, Telangana. Telangana, it is the name of our state. It is the name of a state. State is common noun, and if its name is Telangana, then Telangana is proper noun.
Hyderabad.
Hyderabad is the name of a metropolitan city or a city. Now, city is common noun. When that city has a name, Hyderabad, so Hyderabad will become proper noun.
Last word you can see, Smiti.
For example, you have pet dog at your home. Now dog is a common noun. When you call the dog, your pet dog, Smiti, that Smiti is the name of your pet dog. So Smiti is proper noun. So here you can see S capital letter. So, all the proper nouns must start with a capital letter. And all these proper nouns refers to particular person, particular place or particular things. Particular persons, particular places or particular things. So, my dear students, like common nouns, we have proper nouns, but the rules are different. The way you should understand, the way is different. The rule is different. So I hope you will go through all these examples. Some more examples of common nouns you can write in your notebook. Remember, a common noun should never have a name. A particular name. So you can write few more words, common noun. You can also write few more words, proper nouns. Now I advise you all, go through these two topics and prepare more and more words. As much as you practice, you will get more and more knowledge. If you just look at these words, that is not sufficient. You have to listen, you have to understand, and you have to write, practice more words. Thank you very much, students. All the best.